In these difficult times of COVID-19, getting out of our house is a big challenge. Then how to get AWS certified by giving exam at testing center? Earlier, only AWS Cloud Practitioner exam was allowed to be taken from home. But now AWS has announced that you can take all types of AWS certification exams from home. This was announced on 30th March 2020. Now the big question or the big confusion is, how to take this exam from home? How shall I schedule my exam? And what will be the environment for exam? What kind of rules and policies will be applied when I will be giving my exam? So I will try my best to give answers to most of your these questions. So just keep watching this video. Welcome to my channel SkillPhilip, and in this video we will get to know how to schedule your AWS certification exam, what are the test policies of this exam, how to run the pre-check on your system, and what is the check-in process for the exam. And before we get started, please make sure you hit that subscribe button so that you never miss an update from this channel. So assuming that you have your AWS certification account, so coming to the AWS certification login page, let's try to log in into your account. Click on the sign in button and then based on your account type, just log in into your account. I will select the left hand side option. So here you can enter your email ID and your password for your AWS account, AWS certification account, and then you can log in. Yes, so we have logged in into our AWS certification account, and let's click on to the go to account option. So we are into the home page of AWS training and certification website and click on the upcoming exams tab. As you scroll down, you can see the list of examinations available. So let's try to schedule one exam. Let's say for example, AWS Certified Solution Architect Associate. So as of July 2020, the option of giving exam from home is only available with Pearson VUE, and PSI only allows you to, or they only have the facility of providing the AWS examination assistance through testing center only. So let's select the Pearson VUE option here. So we are getting redirected to the Pearson VUE website. So here they first ask you, how do you want to take your exam? So let's select at home or office. So based on that, they will be going to check your device and network. So one thing which I would like to tell you is, the network or device which you will be planning to use at the time of your exam, you should use that device and network only while the time of pre-check or the system check. So let's click on the run pre-check button. So it will check your microphone, internet speed and webcam compatibility. So once all three green ticks are available here, you can then go back to the Pearson VUE page, and so our system check has been done. So this is just a preliminary or a quick pre-check. The actual pre-check or the system check before giving your exam, before the day of your exam, is still going to happen. This happens usually 1 to 2 days prior to your exam, where you will get a mail regarding the same. Click on the link given in the mail and visit the website to then thoroughly test your system using the Pearson VUE software. So we are going to discuss about that in the upcoming sections. So as of now, let's click on next button. These are some online exam policies listed here. So we are going to go through the detailed exam policies or the FAQs in the upcoming sections. So let's click on the check buttons. I recommend you to go through these in the detailed manner before you actually click on the check. So after ticking all of them, let's proceed. Okay, so select your language. I'm selecting English. And I think as of now, only English is available for giving the exam from home. This is what I read in one of the mails from the Pearson VUE. But again, the policies can change according to the time as the time passes. So let's select English for now and next. So we are into the exam details page. So one thing which I wanted to tell about adding extra 30 minutes to your exam is, currently for giving the exam from home and applying this accommodation, PSM view has stated that the extra 30 minutes recommendation can be applied only by scheduling this exam through phone. So you will need to schedule your exam using the phone by calling on to the service center helpline which they have provided. So let's click on this button. Yeah, so we are into their page, and here based on your region you can check out the helpline numbers which are given here. You can call them in the given time and then get your exam scheduled. They will ask you for your candidate ID and few other details regarding the exam date and time, and based on that you can schedule your exam. So this is one thing which you need to keep in mind if you are going to use the extra 30 minutes option. If you don't want to call them and schedule your exam and just you are fine with not adding extra 30 minutes to your exam, it would be better if you don't apply this accommodation. But for those who have already got their extra 30 minutes accommodation available to your account, then it is again quite difficult to remove that accommodation, because to cancel the same, you need to contact the customer support. So that's one thing you need to remember. So this was one of the cases with using the ESL plus 30 minutes. Now let's check out the option when ESL plus 30 minutes is not applied to your account. So in case your account does not have any special accommodation applied, say for example extra 30 minutes, then you can directly apply for the exam from home option without calling to the center. So let's verify this. First, let's check whether this account is having any accommodation. So as I can see, there is no accommodation requested here. So if your account is not having any special accommodation applied, then on the exam details page, as you saw the same page previously in the previous steps which we followed, it doesn't show any warning here that you need to call Pearson support for scheduling your exam. So this page doesn't show any warning like that, and you can directly go and schedule your exam. So if I click on next, so it shows me the consecutive appointments. I only want to give one exam on a day. I don't want to give multiple exams on a single day. So I'll just select next. So let's select the exam date. Say for example I want to give it on Thursday 30th of July, and I select the time as 3:45 p.m. Then my exam is getting scheduled. Everything seems to be fine. I just need to proceed to checkout, pay the amount, and then my exam will get scheduled. So that was the high level overview of how you can schedule your exam online if you don't have any special accommodations applied to your account. Before actually giving your AWS certification exam from home, we should definitely know what are the test policies provided by Pearson VUE. I have listed down the summary of these test policies here, but before going through them, let's go onto the websites of Pearson VUE and Amazon where they have listed down these test policies in detail. You will get links to this URL in the mail which you get after you schedule your exam, or I have provided these URLs in the description below this video. So let's first go to their website and check the test policies in detail. So we are on the Pearson VUE website, and if we try to scroll down, you will find the additional information section here. Just click on the VUE policies and procedure. Here you can see different FAQs are given, and I would like to highlight some of the important points provided here. So if any other person enters the room while you are testing, your exam will be terminated. You need to remember that. Along with that, what happens if you face technical issues while you are giving your exam? So most of the technical issues can be avoided if you take the system test in advance. And if you have an unstable internet connection and still not able to give your exam properly, if you are stuck in the exam, then the staff is there to handle. They will ping you through the chat and they will help you during your exam. Also, if they are not able to reach you out through the chat, they will call you on your phone number. So going through the details, I wanted to show you one more thing. So are there any workspace requirements? In this section, there are multiple important things highlighted. You need to remember that your desk area should be clutter-free. So it shouldn't have objects like books, notepads, sticky notes, or any other thing within your arm's reach. And also you need to remember the items on the wall shouldn't have anything written on them. There shouldn't be any writing. Then you need to remember no other person can enter your room, and then there shouldn't be any distraction or noise. In such cases, your exam might get terminated, so you need to take care of that. And if we scroll down, wanted to show you one more thing here. Yes, on the exam day, they have also given the instructions or the details how can you start your appointment for your exam. So here are the steps given. One thing I would like to tell you, which is very important, is you should launch your exam 30 minutes prior to your appointment time. Say for example, your appointment is at 3 o'clock, then you should launch your exam or start doing these steps at 2:30, that is half hour before. This is important because you need to complete some formalities. You need to provide your government ID, then the proctor needs to check whether your surroundings are proper, clutter free, and etc. So you need to remember that. And there are many more things in detail provided on this website. I would recommend you to go through all these questions in detail before you actually give your exam. Okay, so coming to another website, so this is the blog by AWS, which also provides the details similar to the one which we saw before. And they will also tell you the details whether you can take a break during your exam. So actually you cannot take any break while your exam is going on. You shouldn't move or leave the webcam view. That's important thing to remember. So go through all these FAQs so that most of your questions or all doubts which you have will get solved. So these are the similar points which we covered in the websites which we saw in detail. You just need to remember few more things, that even your mobile should be kept away from your arm's reach, and eating, drinking, taking breaks, even the washroom breaks are not allowed during your exam. So one piece of advice here is drink limited amount of water so that you won't need to go to the washroom break, and have enough meal before your test so that you don't feel uncomfortable or hungry. And all other things we have covered here. So even mumbling or speaking is not allowed. Try not to speak while you read your question. Even that thing is not allowed. Don't try to cover your face. And even we discussed what happens if the network connection becomes unstable during your exam is going on. So that those are the test policies which you need to remember. You will receive a mail similar to this once you schedule your exam, either 2 to 3 days prior to your exam or immediately once you schedule your exam. So in this mail, they have provided the actions which you need to do before your exam day or on your exam day. So before your exam, you need to follow these 3 steps. First is the system test, second is system requirements. We need to review it, and third is to review the policies and FAQs. So we have already done step 3. Now let's do step 1. So we are on the Pearson View homepage, and here we can see the option to run the system test. You can simply go ahead and click on this button. You will be also told to install a software which will thoroughly do the system test. Okay. Now coming back to mail and checking the second step. So this is the system requirements section, and here you can see they have provided in detail what are the system requirements needed. So you can just go through them, or your system test software will detect if anything is not compatible. Coming back to mail, there are few more things which are told that you need to go through. They will tell you how you should be prepared with the following document, and then you need to check whether your name is properly correct with respect to the government ID and so on. And then these are the steps which you need to follow on the exam day. You need to follow certain steps to begin your AWS certification exam from home. You can find these steps in the mail which I showed you previously. Now let's discuss these steps in detail. So as I told you previously, you need to log in into your account 30 minutes early to start the check-in process and to allow for any troubleshooting. And also, if you became late to join, then you will be unable to start your exam, and then you won't even receive a refund. So you need to be extremely careful about logging in 30 minutes early. Okay, now the steps to begin your exam is, first you need to log in into your AWS certification account. Then you need to select the manage Pearson View exams on the Pearson View dashboard. Then schedule your exam under purchased online exams. Then click on begin exam. and then start your check-in process. And once you are done with your check-in process, then the proctor will contact you and then he will start your exam. So how does this check-in process look like? Here is a snapshot of a check-in process. So before your exam begins, firstly, you need to do your system check. This is the final system check you need to do before you start your exam. Then you need to submit your photo. Your photo will be taken. Then you need to submit your photo identification, that is any government ID. You need to send this photo. You need to upload this photo. Then your workspace will be verified by the proctor. You will need to take your laptop and show your surroundings, whether there is no suspicious item or anything around you. You need to show that to your proctor. And then also, you need to close all other applications which are running in your system. So you need to remember that don't log in into your exam or join your exam using any kind of VPN. And also you need to use the same device and network which you had used earlier when you did your system check. And make sure that there are no other applications running at the time of your exam. Okay. Once all this check-in process pass, then the proctor will automatically allow you in to begin your exam. And after this step, your exam will get started. Don't forget to subscribe this channel, press the bell icon, press that like button, and share this video with all of your friends. Thank you so much for watching, and all the best for your AWS journey.